Okay. All right, I'm recording. This is Joel Freeman. I am with cohort one for Teach Now. And this is my introduction video to my mentor section of clinicals. And this is my mentor. So maybe you could introduce yourself really quickly for my video.
Hello, my name is Faustina Martinez. I am the head of school here at Sangon Livingston American School. And I'm very thrilled to have the opportunity to work with Joel as he completes this program.
All right, thank you. Okay, so what this video is for, this is just the basic introduction and it'll go over the expectations and what I'll be doing this year. So I know I'm gonna be teaching grade two and I created a little document. So I'm gonna share my screen so you could see what I have prepared so far. And obviously this will get longer as the school year goes on. So let me share my screen so I can show you.
Joel, do I need to have my video on the whole time?
You can turn it off now because you've introduced yourself and they've seen you that way. So I could at least show you what I'm doing. So you could turn it off. It's fine.
Great. Okay. Thank you so much. I'm right here.
No problem. No problem. Okay. Let me do my share screen and I'm going to go to the expectations. Okay. All right, so I've got my classroom expectations so far. So this says everyone is treated with kindness and respect. Students will have come to class, completed their assignments, and they should be completed on time. And students will come prepared with their necessary materials. So they have their books, their homework, everything that they need. And obviously we will go through Common Core standards and I will be teaching through social studies, science, language arts, and mathematics. Let me switch to another screen here. Because I have the rubric, which has the clinical standards. So you could see, I'm sure you've seen this document already, but I wanted to make sure we just go over it. So, and that should take a little bit of time, hopefully not too long. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to this. So, yeah, here's the clinical rubric. So it's just what we've got for the 10 in-task model core teaching standards. So this is what we will be doing every time we meet. We will have to talk about this and then I will have to have been at a proficiency level after the end of module 8, which will be in November when I'm gonna be finished with my module 8. So we can look at each standard and I can just read them to you real quick. Okay.
Okay.
Learning standard one is the learner development. So it says the candidate understands how students grow and develop, recognizing that patterns of learning and development vary individually within and across the cognitive, linguistic, social, emotional, and physical areas and designs and implements developmentally appropriate and challenging learning experiences. So that was the first one. So, and we'll be able to have the guiding questions and we can discuss that every time we have the meetings. I'm assuming we have, there are 12 meetings. So there's 12 weeks for the module 8. So, and the other question, does the candidate use strategies that meet students' cognitive, linguistic, social, emotional, and physical needs? Okay. Number two, the candidate uses understanding of individual differences, diverse cultures, and communities to ensure inclusive learning environments that enable each student to meet high standards. We had talked a lot about inclusion today with Narissa, so this is really great. It's a lot of review as well, so that helps. The second guiding question says, does the candidate use knowledge about individual differences and diverse cultures to develop inclusive learning environments that support all students in meeting high standards? So, and especially considering our demographic here at the school, we have a lot of diverse cultures because we have Chinese, Korean, Japanese and American and other nationalities represented within our school. So that would be a really good one to adhere to. Standard three says the candidate works with others to create environments that support individual and collaborative learning and that encourage positive social interaction, active engagement and learning, and self-motivation. The first guiding question says, does the candidate create environments that support individual and collaborative learning, positive social interaction, active engaging in learning, and self-motivation? Okay. The second one says, does the candidate create environments that are student-centered rather than teacher-centered, and do the students have opportunity to make choices? Someone needs to fix that. That's repetitive. Or to take responsibility for their learning. So yeah, one of the things that I did recently with this was talk about learning environments. And one of my cohort members was asking questions about that because the environment plays a very big part in how the kids are going to learn, just because if it's not a welcoming and nurturing environment, the kids will definitely have issues learning. So, does the candidate have established norms and procedures that lead to engaged students, maximum time on task, and logical management of classroom space? Yes, I will definitely be working to have very strict procedures in place with my kids, that they understand what is expected of them, where they're to put their books, whatever. There's going to be procedures for everything with my kids. So the next one, content knowledge, understands the central concepts. It'll take time to go through this, so I'll just breeze through these ones just to say, you know, we're gonna look at the objectives in the lesson plans to get everything sorted and planned the right way. The learning experiences make the discipline accessible and meaningful for students to assure mastery of the concepts, content. And does the student understand subject area concepts and tools of inquiry to make the content accessible and attainable to all students? The next one. Does the candidate use appropriate instructional resources that are comprehensive, accurate, and appropriate for all students? So my goal is to make sure that they understand what it is that they are learning. So I will work really hard to make sure that what they're taught is what they're gonna learn throughout the year. I don't wanna take a lot of your time. I know you're very busy, so I'm just gonna—
Oh no, you're doing— Don't worry, you're fine, okay?
Okay, all right, sure. Okay. Candidate understands how to connect concepts and use different perspectives to engage students in critical thinking, creativity, and collaborative problem solving related to authentic, local, and global issues. I like this one because that relates to our core values that, remember, Jamal was talking about the other day. I think this will definitely apply to how we have our core values here at the school. So this standard is gonna be really emphasized, I think, a lot this year. So I'm looking forward to using that one. Develop and implement lessons that are related to real-world problems relevant to students and interdisciplinary in nature. So I've had to learn a lot about interdisciplinary with my preparations for exams and everything. So this is going to be great, just having a lot of ways to get all of this as I'm learning as I'm going through and working to get all this done. Okay. Understands and uses multiple methods of assessment to engage students in their own growth, monitor student progress, and to guide the candidates and students' decision-making. The guiding question, does the candidate use proper assessment methods to engage students in their own growth, monitor student progress, and guide the candidates' planning? There should be a second question. Does the candidate use the data obtained from assessments in order to monitor student progress and guide planning to better meet the students' learning needs? So again, we just got our portfolio, so we'll be looking at how the students have done for grade one and see where we need to work on areas. If they're short in certain areas, we're gonna work to get them to where they need to be. All right, and there's another question for this one. Does the candidate make proper accommodations and modify testing conditions for special needs students, including English learners in special education. Again, this was something that the school talked about today. Narissa, our director of special education, for those watching my video, she was going through how we as the teachers at the school will be helping students who do have learning needs that require assistance. So this will be a good one to look through with the standards for Teach Now. Standard 7, planning for instruction. Candidates plan instruction that support every student in meeting rigorous learning goals by drawing upon knowledge of content areas, curriculum, cross-disciplinary skills, and pedagogy, as well as knowledge of students and the community context. The guiding question says, does the candidate draw upon knowledge of appropriate instructional strategies and technological tools to plan instruction that supports each student in meeting rigorous learning goals? The guiding question says also, does the candidate plan instruction that follows a logical sequence, moving from easier examples to harder, and including explicit instructions on new concepts? So definitely a scaffolding approach is needed with that, as the concepts will get more involved as we go through the year. It'll start small and work its way up, as to be expected. Standard 8, instructional strategies. Candidate understands and uses a variety of instructional strategies to encourage students to develop deep understanding of content area and their connections, and to build skills to apply knowledge in meaningful ways. The guiding question says, does the candidate use multiple instructional strategies to help students develop deep understanding of content areas and build skills for applying that knowledge in meaningful ways? Okay. The other guiding question says, does the candidate regularly and effectively ask questions to stimulate discussion with the goal of helping students develop higher order thinking skills? I definitely like that one. So, okay. Standard 9, professional learning and ethical practice. Candidate engages in ongoing professional learning and uses evidence to continually evaluate his or her practice, particularly the effects of his or her choices and actions on others. It applies to students, families, other professionals, and the community, and adapts practice to meet the needs of each student. The guiding question, does the candidate participate in professional development and other professional growth experiences this week? So I'm assuming besides my Teach Now, there will be other ways I could get professional development, and I'll figure out which ones I will sign up for besides my classes. The second one says, does the candidate acknowledge that continuous learning and improvement can impact his or her teaching practice through positive changes? Another one, does the candidate design and implement culturally relevant learning experiences for students without any personal bias? Okay. And another one, there are a lot of guiding questions for this one. Does the candidate follow a professional code of ethics and adhere to the relevant laws and policies while teaching and interacting with students? And the final one, the leadership and collaboration. The candidate seeks appropriate leadership roles and opportunities to take responsibility for student learning, to collaborate with students, families, colleagues, and other professionals, community members, to ensure student growth and the advance of the profession. Does the candidate collaborate with the cohort in brainstorming ideas and giving or receiving feedback and helping each other learn and develop? So the cohort in this circumstance would be Rebecca and Myra, because they are my grade 2 team. So Definitely plan a lot of collaboration with them. And we are meeting at 3 o'clock to talk about our lesson plans and everything that we'll have ready for the first week of school when we start this Tuesday. I've got a few more questions. Okay. Does the candidate take responsibility for student learning by collaborating with and leading a team of teachers in cross-curricular or global themes project at school? I'm not sure about leading a team of teachers, but I know I'll be on a team of teachers in this setting. Myra spoke to me about having a map in the classroom, so we're getting that prepared. So we have a social studies project already planned where the kids are gonna identify where they're from and mark it on a map so we could discuss the cultures of the different countries that are represented in the classroom. And we'll find out the details of that today with the lesson planning. The other questions, does the candidate make an attempt to support the school's mission, vision, or goals in the project? So, and makes the mission to make prepare students for success. So obviously that'll be a big part of what I do with my lessons. Does the candidate seek leadership roles in creating and implementing a project that involves faculty, staff, school administration, parents, or community in the project? Obviously, to the people watching the video, the Teach Now community, we might have issues making projects in the community right now due to the COVID pandemic, so there will be limitations on what we do. In this guiding question for the instructor, Glenda Springer, if you're watching this, there will be things that have to be modified. We have two events with our school that are already canceled due to COVID, so we will figure out a way to make this guiding question be answered, obviously in a different format, and it has to adapt. And that's really a big part of what we do as teachers. You have to adapt in the beginning anyway. So, okay, that's the end of the questions. Do you have anything you want to add, Faustina, before I end this?
No, I think this is going to be exciting to watch you grow and develop your understanding of the concepts. I do think that you already have, you know, quite a bit of an understanding since you've been teaching a while. It's just going to be refining your understanding, refining yes. your best practices. But I have a lot of faith in the progress you're going to make this year and in the outcome.
Yes, I'm excited for this. And I think this is going to be a wonderful year and I can't wait to get started. So I'm going to end this video so I can submit it for a lesson. So thanks for your time, Faustina. And thanks to Teach Now. I hope you guys enjoy watching this when it's posted. So thanks again. All right, I'm going to end the meeting, Faustina.
All right, thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye. All right,
bye.